Imagine typing out a movie trailer featuring the adventures of a 30-year-old spaceman wearing a red wool knitted motorcycle helmet, blue sky, salt desert, cinematic style shot on 35mm film, vivid colors, and being given this video as a generated output. Well, believe it or not, this video was created with AI. Now, this AI project is called Sora, which is an AI-generated project from OpenAI. So if you're unfamiliar with the text-to-video concept, it basically just means you give a model some words, which is the prompt, and then it creates a video from those words that you give it. And we've seen generative AI video come out from places like Runway or Dall-E, but Sora looks different. Let's get into the research and see what we have so far. From the published research on OpenAI's website, we see videos like this. I mean, we have mammoths just walking in the snow. Here we have a lady walking on the street. It's very cinematic. If you look at the people in the background, you can see their legs are a little bit weird at times. But other than that, like the signs, the perspective, everything sort of stays in the same position, like it's a normal real life shot, which is really, really cool. And then when you zoom in, the details on her face are just amazing. And it looks like it's all just one person. I mean, look at the sideburns. She has crazy sideburns. Incredible. Now, it's important to note that this AI is still not publicly available as it's still in development, and it's only been released to a select few people to continue testing. And rightfully so. I mean, it's clear that this model still has a bunch of issues. I mean, for example, if we look at this shot, look at the cat's arm as it comes up. The right arm sort of becomes the left arm. See, the arm comes up here and turns into the left arm, and then the right arm's back down. And there's small things like the covers here flopping over her face. Like, where did that part of the cover come from? Just a little strange. And things like the physics, they're definitely still trying to figure out. But let's be honest here, no technology is perfect, especially AI-related technology. So while Sora has its limitations, describing these complex emotions or concepts can be tricky, and the output might not always match your exact vision. Obviously, these videos are very tailored to make it look good. Let's watch another one here with a very simple prompt, the Chinese New Year celebration with a dragon. And as you can see here, there are a lot of people. Like, we have a crowd. I'm looking at the individual people and I can't see like a lot actually really wrong with it. Now, obviously with things like these, like look at what's holding up the dragon at the front there. The hands are kind of weird. And also like AI doesn't really know what's holding up the dragon. Like, it doesn't really look like there's a whole lot actually holding it up. But obviously here I'm focusing more on the negatives. So like, look at this shot. This is cool. Let's focus on the positives here. Where are you gonna get a shot where you just have a long windy road and then you have this specific car just driving down it? Like, if you're making a movie and you want to make a chase scene, you could just do that with AI instead of spending millions of dollars to actually do it with your movie budget. That being said, shots like these will not be free. But I think what's more important is that pretty much anyone now can create shots like this for a low subscription or maybe a token-based fee, and they can generate scenes for their movies, generate some B-roll for their videos, maybe do some 3D animations, and so much more. Like, the opportunities are just endless. Obviously, now more than ever, video is a crucial part of any sort of business, whether it's entertainment or informational. Now, although maybe this isn't quite at the professional level of like Hollywood, or using it in professional looking videos for your business, it's pretty damn close, which is crazy, because if you look back only a year or two ago, we were struggling to generate simple images, which is why I think you can maybe deny this for now as a viable solution for your video needs, but within a matter of years, I don't even think decades, we are gonna have shots that you can just use for any purpose, which is insane. Obviously, when you're using AI, it's trained off a bunch of previously shot videos and images, so you're not maybe gonna have the ingenuity of actual humans, and the AI might not be creative enough to come up with its own shots, but it's gonna be a really good placeholder for people who either don't know how to make video themselves, or just don't have the budget. Now, I don't usually like to cover things that aren't currently tangible, but this announcement just felt too crazy to be true. I mean, look at this. You have her reflection as she's driving by a city, and then you see her face, and then it's back to the reflection again. I mean, that's incredible. So is OpenAI's Sora the future of video creation? It's too early to say, but it's definitely a major step forward, and I am both scared and very excited to see what it turns into. I want to know what you think about this down in the comments, if you're frightened by this or if you're just excited to be able to use this technology at some point. Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one.